This will be the first project wherein we are extensively studying this glaciated system for snow, glacier, permafrost and atmospheric dynamics.
I have been concentrating most of my research work on understanding the behavior of Himalayan cryosphere to climatic and anthropogenic changes. We are monitoring snow, we are monitoring glaciers, and we are monitoring permafrost also. We have established a network of around 30 in-situ observation sites, wherein we are monitoring in-situ temperature or temperature of the soil, permafrost soil, across 6 different mountain ranges. I mean, so we have more than 50,000 glaciers in the entire Hindu Kush, Karakoram, Himalayan Arc. And this Himalayan Arc is also termopause along with some glaciers in Central Asia and Tibetan Plateau, the third pole, because it has the highest concentration of glaciers outside the polar regions. And we know that glaciers in this region have been retreating at alarming pace as compared to other mountain regions. And this glacier retreat not only poses basically risk to, say, water availability, but in light of the changing climate, some emerging cryosphere-related disasters have emerged. So it becomes very important and paramount to monitor the cryospheric reserves in terms of snow, in terms of glaciers, and in terms of permafrost, or the different components of cryosphere or water cycle that we have. If you look at the Himalayan wide estimates of how many observation sites of glaciers we have, we do not have more than 30 glacier sites wherein in-situ monitoring of glaciers is being carried out. In the cryosphere, what we wanted to do is we did not want enough number of, large number of sites to be monitored, but one small glaciated catchment wherein we can study all the three components of the cryosphere, the snow, the glaciers and the permafrost. And then the atmospheric interactions that these systems have, in terms of how they are thawing or how they behave under varying climatic or environmental responses. We have chosen a catchment called Chalong Catchment, which is located in the upstream of a village called Panikhar. Panikhar is a village in Kargil district, and this village has a lot of dependence in terms of the waters that come from the upstream areas in terms of glaciers that it has, the rock glaciers that it has, or the permafrost that it has. But then in the winter, it is massively covered by snow, and all these components of the cryosphere basically regulate the irrigation or supplement the irrigation needs of this downstream village. And under this project, we are looking at, establishing one glacier as a mass balance site where we can do extensive mass balance studies. We want to drill a shallow ice core so that we can reconstruct maybe past 20 or 30 years of what is the atmospheric deposition happening on these glaciers. And if there are particulates like micro or nanoplastics or even black carbon, which have been reported to be climate forces in terms of causing the damage or degradation or degeneration of glaciers in this region. Looking at this Lamo Lake, which has a glow of risk associated with it, one of the first-hand inputs which has a direct bearing on the policy making as far as glow of mitigation is concerned is the bathymetry and the modeling of this potential glow of that is imminent over the village. We are installing around 15 temperature data loggers in the Chalong or in this Lamo catchment upstream of Panikhar, and the idea is to get basically thermal variations of the permafrost, or what are the thermal fluctuations that are happening in the active layer of the permafrost. Because if you look at the Himalayan region, we do not have any in-situ measurements of the active layer dynamics, thermal activities of active layer dynamics of the permafrost. So under this project, it will be a first initiative of its kind wherein we have a very detailed observation of what is happening at, say, something like 3500 meters above the sea level and what is happening at something like 5000 or 5200 meters above the sea level. So we will be covering an entire altitudinal gradient. And as far as the location of this village is concerned, this is approximately 100 kilometers from the main headquarters of Kargil, and it is a very important catchment in that sense and a very important project which has tremendous scientific as well as societal benefits.